So what's the difference between a software engineer and a software developer, between a coder and a computer programmer? I'm going to talk about that in today's video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka and this is another programming tip of the day. And the video is all about determining the differences between these terms. We've got a software engineer, we've got a software programmer, we've got a computer programmer, we've got a coder. So what are the differences between these? Are these different jobs or do they all sort of end up being the same? Well, firstly, keep in mind that there's really no one standard way of dealing with these terms. In other words, when you get into industry, you'll find that you might find a programming job that has different titles, but is essentially the same position. But in general, what I'll do is I'll start off by talking about what I believe the fundamental differences are between them. Starting off with coder. Now, generally, a coder would be someone who is starting out in the industry, you know, perhaps new to programming, and this would be someone who's got the absolute basics of programming. You know, perhaps they've done a course, done some training, and it's their first programming job. So it could be like a coder would be a common name for that position, or a junior programmer. So they're not really involved in any design. They're usually given their work, and they've got a specific part of an application or a specific sort of scope of responsibilities which relate to programming something. Now, as you progress up, you'll become to like a computer programmer or a software developer. Those terms generally is still talking about programming, but I would see that they would be more advanced programmers. So someone with more experience, someone who knows a bit more, has been working in the field for a few more years. Very common to see a job with those, with either of those terms, computer programmer, software developer. Now, getting to software engineer or software engineering in general, this can be classified more as the design side of things. So in other words, you're not just programming. You haven't got to someone coming to you with a design and saying, program this. You're more an architect. So you're designing, you've got you're putting some work into designing the application as well. So software engineer can be involved in that process of architecting, designing the program, and just, you know, figuring out what functionality is going to be in there. You know, perhaps really coming up with a blueprint. So and the analogy there would be a software engineer could be something like an architect. So an architect builds a plan for a house. So that would be the software engineer. And the architect then gives the designs, the blueprints, if you will, for a house to a builder. The builder would be the computer programmer or software developer. So in general, that's what those terms and the differences are. But in practice, you find there's a lot of overlap. For example, a software engineer will often be a coder as well. They'll often be a software developer. So they'll not only design applications, but they'll actually be building the applications, writing the code themselves. And also, you'll find that there's actually a role also for a software architect. So a software architect is someone who specializes in architecting applications. So the point of all this is there's a lot of overlap between these terms. Not everyone out there agrees. So there's no really one way of categorizing what the various roles are. So in general, you'll find that there's a lot of blurring of the lines between these positions. But if you keep in mind what I've talked about, the principal changes or differences, I should say, between these roles, that'll give you a good general idea of what the industry looks at in terms of these roles and what each role ultimately does. So I hope that helps today. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here and I'll see you soon.